إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى عن نبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. It is he who sent his messenger with guidance and the religion of truth to manifest it over all religion, and sufficient is Allah as witness. Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is Sayyid Walad Adam. He is the leader of mankind. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خير البرية, the best creation صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is our role model. He said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And indeed you are of a great moral character. We have to know his akhlaq to follow his akhlaq, his morals, his behavior, his conduct, his way to treat the wife, the children, the friends, everything. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said about himself, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by Allah, I am the most God conscious among you, and I fear him most among you. أخشاكم لله وأتقاكم له, which means you don't know, you cannot worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way better than his way. You should not innovate anything in Islam, because there is nothing, there is nothing better than the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-abd al-shakur. He used to do a long qiyam, not for 1 hour or 2 hours, more than that. He used to offer night prayers till his feet became swollen. Somebody said to him, telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the point to make like that qiyam? Allah has forgiven you your faults of the past and those to follow. He said immediately, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should not I be a thankful slave of Allah? When you read about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you'll come across many ahadith like this hadith. The family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only him, also his family, had not eaten wheat bread to their satisfaction for 3 consecutive days since his arrival at Medina till he died. How many years? 10 years in Medina. They did not fill their stomach, he and his family, 3 days. Subhanallah. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. نعمان بن بشير سيد عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه gave a خطبة. He mentioned what the people had acquired of worldly gains, which means after the life of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, a lot of jihad, a lot of wealth came to the Muslim Ummah. So Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه said, I saw Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم remaining curled up with hunger pangs all day, unable to find even the worst type of dates with which to fill his stomach. The worst, daql, the worst type of date. This is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Sayyid Walad Adam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the victory, after victory, the booty was coming to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم from the jihad. He was the most generous صلى الله عليه وسلم. He was not saving money for the future. He was not saving the money for his children, grandchildren, the next generation. كان أجود الناس صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما سئل عن شيء قط فقال له صلى الله عليه وسلم. It never happened that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked for anything for the sake of Islam. He did not give that. He will give صلى الله عليه وسلم. He will not say no. If he has, immediately he will give the dunya صلى الله عليه وسلم. They came to him, a person, and he gave him a large flock of sheep and goats. And he went back to his people. Then he said, my people, embrace Islam for Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. For Muhammad gives so much charity as if he has no fear of poverty. He doesn't fear the poverty because the rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was given sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a gift, a sheep. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat on his knees sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to eat. A Bedouin man saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For this Bedouin man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a king, a leader, the greatest man, sitting in a way that the slaves are sitting. What is this? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to that Bedouin man and to the whole world, Allah has made me a humble and generous slave of Allah and has not made me arrogant and stubborn. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا عَنِيدًا صلى الله عليه وسلم. We should learn from his akhlaq صلى الله عليه وسلم. Aisha رضي الله تعالى عنها says that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم never beat anyone with his hand. Anyone. Neither a woman nor a servant. And of course, a child. How many times we are beating our children, our wives, our maids? We don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in beating them, the poor, the weak people. We should follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The problem, when we claim we are following the sunnah, and at home we are against the sunnah. Where is the sunnah? At home, where is the sunnah with your slaves or with your maid, with your child, with yourself? She said radiyallahu ta'ala anha, but only in the case when he had been fighting in the cause of Allah. This is wajib because jihad. Then she said, and he never took revenge for anything unless the things made inviolable by Allah were made violable. heathen took revenge for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما ينتقم لنفسه. Because he insulted me, he spoke bad about my tribe. Never, nothing like that. But when the issue is about the salah, the issue is about the hijab, the issue is about the Quran, you'll find him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very strict. He'll not keep silent, defending the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jarir ibn Abdullah, after accepting Islam, he said a great statement, radiyallahu ta'ala an, ma hajabani النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منذ أسلمت ولا رآني إلا تبسم. He did not screen himself from me since I embraced Islam. سبحان الله. The leader of the Muslim Ummah, he was open for people. Anyone is welcome to come and meet Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. No need for appointment. No need to wait. Directly you can go and you meet and you speak to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Not only that, he said, Jarir, and whenever he saw me, he would receive me with a smile. Sallallahu alayhi wasallam and radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam kana ashja'u an-nas. Was the best, the bravest, and the most generous of all people. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once, Anas radiallahu ta'ala described, once when the people of Medina got frightened, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rode a horse and went ahead of them and said, we found his horse very fast. Lan tura'u. Don't worry. Before everyone, he went alone, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to check what is there. Then he came back telling them, don't worry. Which means, kana ashja'u an-nas, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, aqul ma tasma'un, astaghfirullah li wa lakum. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. When we read the history of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when we come to know the great behavior of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was brave, he was generous, he was humble, he was simple, he was pure صلى الله عليه وسلم, سيد ولد آدم. This doesn't mean that he did not suffer in his life. He went through many calamities, very tough tests, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was patient. He lost his father. He did not see his father. He was yatim. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described in the Quran, he was an orphan, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also he lost his mother when he was about 6 years old. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He lived in Mecca. His people, Quraysh, and they were fighting him when he started the da'wah to Islam. He escaped from Mecca and he stayed in the ghar 3 days. Ghar Thawr, between Mecca and Medina. The Yahud, la'anahumullah, Jews, may Allah curse them, put the poison for him in the food. And they did the magic for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of his children passed away during his life, except Fatima. He lost 6 of his children during his life, except Fatima, radiallahu ta'ala, anhum ajma'een. His people fought him, and they were to kill him in Ghazwat Uhud. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. He said to Aisha, لَقَدْ لَقِيتُ مِنْ قَوْمِكِ مَا لَقِيتُ. I faced great troubles from your people, which means Quraysh. That he did not suffer like that. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And there are many things to learn from the seerah, the biography of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The point here, how to be with him صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, إن من أحبكم إلي وأقربكم مني مجلسا يوم القيامة أحاسنكم أخلاقا. The dearest and the closest of you to me on the day of resurrection will be those who are the best in behavior. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So this is the point. How to be with him, صلى الله عليه وسلم. How to get the nearest position with the Prophet, صلى الله عليه وسلم, to follow his akhlaq, عليه الصلاة والسلام. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات, إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم احفظ الشباب والبنات من المخدرات ومن الزنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم نجي إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اللهم حرر المسجد الأقصى من أيدي اليهود الغاصبين. اللهم نجي إخواننا المسلمين في غزة. اللهم احفظهم, اللهم استر عوراتهم وآمن روعاتهم. احفظ إخواننا المسلمين في السودان وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين. اجمع الأمة الإسلامية على التوحيد والسنة يا رب العالمين. آمين. اللهم وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم ارزقهم بطانة صالحة وجنبهم بطانة سيئة يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظنا من الأوبئة والأمراض السيئة القوية يا رب العالمين. اللهم تقبل صلاتنا. اللهم بلغنا رمضان وارزقنا فيه الصلاة والقيام والصدقات وتقبلها منا يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوان الحمد لله رب العالمين.